over the next 5 years, you will still see financial services industry and a customer experience journey which is even more evolved than it has been in the last 5. I think the bigger thing that we've got to wrestle with is the norms for data. And frankly, that is not a regulatory question. That's a question of society acceptance of what is right and what is not right. The idea that I can walk down the street and with my Google glasses, I know everything about your whole life from your digital footprint, that's a little creepy. So I think that challenge of trying to define social norms and social mores, what makes it okay and what makes it not okay, will probably be a trickier challenge to me than the regulatory challenge. The interface device of choice today is the mobile phone. I don't think that will necessarily be the case. With IoT and 5G, in the next 5 years, you will see a lot more different kinds of interface devices, including augmented reality, including appliance and device-based initiation, and so on. I think data has been the big differentiator. So if you really want to create unique customer journeys, you can really be customer-obsessed if you understand data. Customer science, instrumentation, and big data is a game-changer. And then on top of that, if you apply artificial intelligence, that can dramatically change the nature of the game. That's not static. So that's changing every day as we speak. Digital banks do create the capacity of new ways of thinking. And to a large extent, it is about partnerships. So you can bring new partnerships to bear on the solutions. In some cases, it is about niche opportunities that are unfulfilled. So in many countries, you have a large underbelly of underbanked, which the banking system has not addressed. And a new digital bank, particularly take M-Pesa in Africa, and they targeted and addressed a completely unaddressed part of the market. So you have a bunch of different things digital banks can do. I do think that in countries, Singapore is an example, where the current banks have also made a lot of progress in terms of a digital range of solutions, market opportunities are less clear. One challenge is the challenge everybody faces. Technology is eating every industry alive, so there are no industry boundaries, which means everybody can be a financial services player, including the individual and the consumer. So you really have to reimagine, rethink what it means to be a bank or a financial service entity, and how do you deal with new sets of expectations and norms, and that's a big challenge. I talked about the social risks around data, artificial intelligence, financial inclusion versus exclusion. We haven't got our hands around many of these things. They're more mundane, but risks around cybersecurity. With quantum computing, if it really comes, every crypto and every algorithm that we create today can be bust like that. So, you know, how do you deal in a world where if your life is digital, but, you know, more of cybersecurity becomes a bigger issue? So I think you've got to be keep a careful eye on the risks that this creates. And while, therefore, you push innovation, you just need to be mindful that society and the infrastructure and system needs to evolve in pace.